SDSU is going to the national tournament for the fourth straight year.
Well, if we've made it look easy, it's because we've had great players, and great players always make good coaches. So we love the fact that our great players have gotten things done for us. And it's not easy because those women put a lot of time into it, a lot of effort into it. And this year we're going to need the same from our four seniors. They've got to be great leaders for us, and they've got to kind of elevate their games and get them to a point where they can play like a Jenny Sonnenberg and a Jill Young. And we're going to need that from them. And if we get that, we should have a good chance again.
Young and Sonnenberg both graduated as 1,000-point scorers and multiple-time all-league selections. So this year's team will feature a lot of contributing players who will have to take on larger roles.
You know, Ashley's been a complimentary player, Leah has been, Steph has been, Katie has been. All of them have been great seniors, but we're also going to rely on some of those young players. Somebody like Megan Watashik, who really hasn't had a chance to shine yet because of injury, we expect her to be a great player, one of the best players we have right now. We also look at some other young players like Gabby Bover, someone who played a backup role last year, has got a chance to be a great point guard, potentially starter for 3 years. And so we're really kind of turning the page and in a good way that we're going to have a lot of new people have to step up. And that'll be fun. As a coach, that's energizing. I think it'll be fun for our fans, too.
Another question mark is the health of senior guard Steph Pollock, who suffered a season-ending knee injury in last year's Summit League tournament.
Steph is just coming back here this September into 5-on-5. Although Steph's really ahead of schedule, I still don't know if she's going to be quite 100% yet, so we're going to wait and see as we get a little bit closer and make a decision.
Johnston says depth will again be a potentially huge advantage for the Jacks.
We feel like the pace of our game needs to speed up again. We think we got a little bit more half-court orientated the last couple years, and now I think we need to open things up again, and depth will be a big part of that. But the other thing our depth will do is kind of allow us to lean on different players every night. Until we establish one player or two players that we know have to have the ball at the end of a game, it might be kind of game by game. And when you have a lot of players that can get things done, that's a nice luxury.
In the nothing new department, AJ and his staff have once again put together a challenging non-conference schedule.
Good balance, I think, in terms of home games, away games, really fun games here in Frost. I think getting a chance to see Nebraska, really going to be one of the best teams in the Midwest. They are very talented. At least one player on their team has a chance to be an All-American type player. Then we're going to have a team like Marquette come back, another Big East team that's been here before. And then some great kind of familiar rivalries like a Middle Tennessee, you and I, we've played. We'll introduce Creighton to the arena, Eastern Michigan. So we've got some really good fun games. Then we'll go to Georgetown, who will come back the next year, and to Penn State, who will come back.
SDSU is a heavy favorite to repeat as league champion, garnering 22 of a possible 25 first place votes in the league's preseason poll.
This is a good team, a really good team. We've improved at the point guard position too, with Gabby having a year experience. Chloe as a freshman has been great, and I think they'll have a chance to play for us. So in a lot of ways, we're deeper and a little bit more balanced than we have been in the past.